Baza YouTube, 6 foot hacks here, bringing y'all to daily team builder for week number 4 of the NPA. Apologize for no face cam, having that desync issue again. I had this issue a couple weeks ago. Hopefully it doesn't happen again. If it happens again, then I'll worry more about it when that does come around. But yeah, no face cam for this team builder. But we are facing Kanto Cast Blue, coach of the Tapu Koko Puffs, which is currently 3-0 heading into this week, and we are 2-1 coming off of a very, very crazy victory against Redithin last week, which was the number one team heading into week number 3. So hopefully we can continue that momentum past this week's NPA match and head into week 5 3-1 instead of 2-2, and we can maybe end another streak here. We'll see how things go. But yeah, as you can see in the bottom left hand corner is the team matchup. Let me know what you guys would have brought to this match. Was it exactly what I brought, or maybe it was something different? Would be interested to see what you guys potentially wanted to bring to this matchup. So the main thing about this matchup is that he has a disgusting core of Cresselia and Blissey, which thankfully we are able to break through that. It's just a matter of what we want to break through them with, essentially. Because Cresselia, there's no way I can like one-shot Cresselia. It's way too bulky. Almost the same thing with Blissey. I kind of expect Choppleberry Blissey if he brings Blissey. Blissey covers a lot of my, especially offensive Mons, so that's definitely going to be a problem. Nidalgo could be a bit of an issue depending on the set. The combination of Mega Pidgeot plus Gyarados is very terrifying, just because we don't have the best flying resist, but at the same time, Gyarados really isn't that big of a threat. Well, it's not as big of a threat as much as Mega Pidgeot is, because we can deal with Gyarados a little bit better than we can with Mega Pidgeot. So Mega Pidgeot is a giant terrifying offensive threat, and his wall core Blissey and Cresselia is also kind of an issue. The bottom five Mons, I'm not really too sure if he is going to bring them. I'm not really too worried about Murkrow. Don't really care about Hitmonchan. I have a Dredagon and a Garbodor and a Manaphy, along with the Hydreigon, which Hydreigon could easily come to this matchup scarfed if I really wanted to bring it. So I honestly don't expect Darmanitan. And then Vikabolt or Rhyperior may possibly come over something, but I think the top six are what he may mainly want to bring. Actually, I skipped over Bulu. Bulu isn't as terrifying. Like, it's a little bit annoying, but it's a lot easier to deal with Bulu than it is with like Mega Pidgeot, Nidalgo, and Gyarados, essentially. So yeah, let's go ahead and get this started. Our first team member here is going to be Sugarpuff, aka Slurpuff, making her debut for the Durham Dredagons in the NPA. Now, we did have Slurpuff for a brief moment in P4G, but I dropped it after the first 2 weeks. However, though, up until week 4, finally, we get to bring her in the NPA, and I'm actually really excited for Slurpuff in this matchup, because this legitimately just sweeps after a belly drum. All we have to do is get off 40-ish percent of damage on Cresselia, about 40%, so we don't have to hopefully get absolute min and knock it out. Like, I think the minimum damage we do with plus 6 play rough is like 58%, so if we get off at least 40% on Cresselia, then as long as I don't get lowballed, we'll be fine. But this is kind of going to be setting up on Cresselia or the Blissey, so if we're able to weaken Cresselia enough, then that's going to be really amazing. Thanks to the HP investment, if the Cresselia for some reason does not have Psychic, or let's say he's locked into some type of non-stab move, because we do have a Trick Mon going into this matchup, then this subs belly drums and just wins, essentially. So my main plan going into this matchup is either use Cresselia or Blissey to set up on. That's why we have substitute, so we can sub up on a potential Thunder Wave, Toxic. I don't know what else they would potentially carry. Or if they go for an offensive move outside of Seismic Toss and stab Psychic, there's no way he breaks my substitute, which is super nice. And then between Play Rough and Drain Punch, we hit everything for neutral or super effective damage to just Oko everything at plus 6, except for Cresselia and Rhyperior, which it's a lot easier to wear down Rhyperior than it is to wear down Cresselia. So essentially, if this gets up a sub and gets up to plus 6, I think at that point it's game, because then from there I can manhandle through Cresselia and guarantee you to a KO if I haven't been able to get rid of it. So this is mainly going to be here to try and set up on Cresselia, something locked into something that it's not supposed to be locked in, and potentially on Blissey as well if he decides to bring them. So yeah, moving on to the next team member here, we have Damien the Dreadagon, the mascot of the Durham Dreadagons, making his debut for the MPA here. And the great thing about Dreadagon in this matchup is that this deals with physically offensive Bulu and Darmanitan. Essentially, this is the main reason why Dreadagon is here. It's to deal with those two very pesky walls, not walls, well, wall breakers I should say, or just very, very offensive, physically offensive mons. Also, this can kind of deal with the Murkrow and the Hitmonchan if for some reason he wants to bring them. I doubt he brings all four together because that would be just a little bit odd, but at least one or two of the four I'm fully expecting to come to this matchup. And this week's set is a little bit odd. I know you guys see the speed EVs. That is actually enough speed to outspeed a potential speed creeping Blissey, because for some reason, this dragon doesn't outspeed big ol' Blissey. I don't know why, but yeah, we do have to take some defense EVs off and put him into speed, but that's fine because we're still going to be chewing hits from the Bulu, Darmanitan, Hitmonchan, Murkrow, potentially the Gyarados as well, which is super nice. Taunt comes in handy to be able to taunt Blissey so we can wear it down a lot easier and potentially beat it 1v1. He most likely is going to bring Seismic Toss on the Blissey because he can just spam it against our team, so that way we can get Rocky Helmet damage and Rough Skin damage, stop it from Stealth Rocking, Thunder Waving, Toxicking, or potentially getting a recovering stealth rocks. Yeah, I don't really know what I was going on about there for a second, but yeah, Dragon Claw doesn't do entirely too much, but it's fine. And then Gunk Shot just straight murders Bulu. Like, there's no way around Bulu not just dying to Gunk Shot unless he has the Kabaya Berry, which I highly doubt, because something like Band-Aid or Sword Dance Bulu makes a lot of sense. Actually, I could kind of see him bringing Dazzling Gleam, but Bulu's special attack isn't entirely too good, so I'm not really concerned about that. Maybe Nature's Madness over Dazzling Gleam would make a lot of sense, I think. But yeah, Dreadagon has a pretty solid matchup this game here. And next off, we have No making her return after making her debut last week. This is a pretty awesome set that I'm hoping can actually put in a lot of work. Shouts out to my boy ShuckleKing87. I am Wombo, and Harris for helping me with this week's squad here. So the great thing about Zatud in this matchup is that even if he brings Murkrow, there's nothing Murkrow can do to me. Like, I don't really know what a Murkrow can do to a physically, well, kind of physically defensive Zatud with Toxic, because I can just Toxic him, then Calm Mind, Roost, and eventually once Murkrow goes down, this is free to spam Psyshock against his entire team. This set can also beat Cresselia 1v1. If we Toxic Cresselia, we can start Calm Minding, as he will have to eventually go for some type of recovery move. I fully expect Ice Beam on the Cresselia. That's why I'm not too concerned about something like Sub Calm Mind Cresselia, although we do have ways of dealing with that. I feel like he wouldn't want to bring Sub Calm Mind Cresselia because he wants to have those two offensive moves instead of just being mono attacking or having no stab in general. So this is where Zatu can come in handy and beat that 1v1. The Chardy Berry is super nice for the Darmanitan if he tries to Rock Slide me. It's nice for Stone Age Bulu, potentially Rhyperior. I know if he's got Rock Blast, it will only work on the first Rock Blast hit, unfortunately, but if he has Stone Edge, then we can easily chew that. Also, Nilego, if we get up to plus one Spadef with the Chardy Berry, we guarantee live a Nilego's Power Gem, and then we just Oko him with the Psyshock, which Nilego is a little bit scary, honestly, going into this matchup, but we have something pretty awesome to deal with that. Next off, we have Mega Gallade, aka Ric Flair, and the great thing about Mega Gallade in this matchup is that with us having two mons with Substitute, if I show him sub on Gallade early on in the match, he may not expect me to have sub on the Slurpuff, which could actually really come in handy for us, or vice versa. And much like Slurpuff, if Gallade gets behind a Substitute and sets up, then there's not really too much he's going to be able to prevent me from just absolutely annihilating. Bulu gets straight to a KO'd unless he's like max defense and max HP. Same thing for Gyarados, even though we don't have a super effective move against them. If we're behind a sub at plus two, you can better believe Mega Gallade is going to manhandle through any type of wall if it has the appropriate coverage moves for it, or just a stab and something that doesn't matter if it's resistant. You get what I'm trying to say? Like, Mega Gallade is super strong, and we are running enough speed to outspeed Nilego, so if for some reason he doesn't have a Choice Scarfer, once the Mega Pidgeot is gone, this outspeeds everything. And Substitute actually does really help us against a Mega Pidgeot, because otherwise, Even after getting a KO, Mega Pidgeot comes in for free, and Mega Pidgeot already is a giant terror to this team. Like, Mega Pidgeot is the sole, like, destructive mon that he could bring, and if he doesn't bring it for some reason, I would be absolutely surprised, honestly. So yeah, Mega Glade, pretty awesome offensive mon here. And speaking of Mega Pidgeot, we have some pretty nice fire here with Assault Vest Manaphy. Now, I know this seems weird and it seems odd. I know some of you guys may be a little bit skeptical of the set and upset if you have used Manaphy before. I've never really used Manaphy. I've never really been a big fan of Manaphy, but I feel in this matchup like that this set could honestly really, really help out with the Mega Pidgeot problem of this team. So the great thing about this spread is that a Hurricane from Max Special Attack Mega Pidgeot is a 4-hit KO. That means I can switch into this two times before I am put in range of where he can 2-hit KO me on the next switch-in, which is more than enough switch-ins that I need in order to be able to deal with the Mega Pidgeot. Plus, he's brought Defog U-Turn Mega Pidgeot a lot, so if I'm able to get up rocks in this match, then every time I force it in and out, then I can apply offensive pressure, or I knock him out on the turn that he tries to defog, and then at that point I no longer have to deal with Mega Pidgeot. But this set is specifically made to pivot into Mega Pidgeot and ensure that it cannot destroy us. Because of Icy Wind, after we go for the Icy Wind, we are then faster than Mega Pidgeot the following turn, so that's really good. Scald is very spammable against his team because he doesn't really have anything that wants to get burned except for Cresselia, or I suppose the Blissey, which we have U-Turn to potentially catch those on a switch-in and gain momentum from the Pidgeot switching out, or him going for U-Turn and then knockoff is going to be really nice to be able to scout for berries, items, Z-Crystals potentially as well. So this Manaphy set can actually put in a lot of work, and I'm really hoping that it does, because if this set does work out to perfection, then Manaphy will have grown a little bit more on me. So moving on to the final team member, we have, of course, our trusty lawnmower, the Rotom Mo here, aka Mojado. And the cool thing about Rotom Mo being scarfed in this matchup is that his only way of stopping me from clicking Volt Switch is Rhyperior, which gets absolutely blown back by Leaf Storm. So a part of me really does not expect them to bring Rhyperior. And because this can naturally outspeed Gyarados and outspeeds if we are scarfed, that's why I'm a little bit iffy on whether or not he may want to bring Gyarados. But a flying spam core between Gyarados and Mega Pidgeot is way too scary and something that I do need to prepare for regardless. So obviously Scarf Nidalgo and Scarf Darmanitan will be able to outspeed this, but if I put myself in a position of where I'm sacking this off, then I can maybe gain information on one of the two that finish me off. Also, another great thing about Assault Vest Manaphy is that we can consistently switch in to the Nidalgo as well and guarantee that even boosted, it shouldn't be that big of an issue for us to deal with. So if he doesn't have Scarf Nidalgo or Scarf Darmanitan, this outspeeds them. Volt Switch is very free against his entire team if he doesn't bring Rhyperior, and that's absolutely huge because I will be able to gain momentum into my Slurpuff, into my Mega Gallade, or even my Zatu, allowing them to all potentially set up, and that'll be absolutely amazing. Trick is mainly for the Blissey, because if I find out that he's running like Z Crystal Cresselia, then I can't trick that, so I have to be a little bit more careful. But the main thing about Trick is to shut down one of his two fat walls and then hopefully use them as setup fodder for Slurpuff in the back. So yeah, guys, that is going to be our team for this week. We have some pretty awesome sets that I'm really hoping we'll be able to put in some work. And let me know in the comment section below what you guys would have possibly brought to this week four game for the Durham Dredagons. And with that being said, I will see you all tomorrow with the actual battle itself. So later, everybody.
No matter where you're at, I'm not here to make friends. It's time to attack and deplete your HP with a final smash. Don't make me turn around and pull a 6-foot hacks.
6-foot hacks. Hacks. 6-foot hacks. Hacks. 6-foot hacks. Hacks.